My name is Tomás Fernández and I'm presenting the work titled Analysis of the Evolution of Gully Erosion in Olive Groves Using Photogrammetry Techniques, Relationships with Rainfall Regime. In representation of a research team of the University of Jaén from several departments. This is a structure of the work starting from the introduction. Soil erosion is a global phenomenon of environmental degradation, and within it, gully erosion represents 50 to 80% of total erosion at basin scales. Geomatic techniques allow the precise characterization of this phenomenon by means of several techniques such as total extension, GNSS, and especially massive point cloud procedures, LiDAR techniques, but mainly by means of image-based approaches using photogrammetric or computer vision techniques. Then, images and orthoimages allow surface characterization and, on the other side, generation of digital elevation models for estimation of gully depths and volumes. Moreover, multitemporal analyses are addressed with calculation of digital elevation models of differences. In this paper, we have developed a methodology for quantification of gully erosion based on photogrammetry, aerial and UIS, and LiDAR techniques. The study area of 1.8 hectares is composed mainly by Triassic rutile and sandstones. It is an active gully stretch with intense erosion processes, sometimes affecting two rural roads and paths. Regarding the materials, a set of 8 historical aerial flights from 1980 to 2016 at quake from different cartographic agencies were used with resolution between 0.27 and 0.45 meters. We downloaded the images from the photo libraries of National Geographic Institute of Spain and Statistical and Cartographic Institute of Andalusia. Besides, LiDAR data correspond to the first national LiDAR coverage, which has captured in 2014 in the Andalusia region with a resolution of 1.5 square meters. They can be accessed via the download service of Geographical Institute. Meanwhile, a DGA Phantom 4 with RTK module integrated of centimeter accuracy and a camera of 20 megapixel is used. Other GNSS equipment have been employed for ground control and checkpoints. Then the methodology starts with the data capture. The data capture was made by means of 2 UIS flights of very high resolution with a ground sample distance of 2-3 cm. For the first flight, on April 2019, a set of 30 ground control points and checkpoints were measured by means of differential GNSS. This has the properties of flights. The other flight was made on February 2020. Once the data have been acquired on and or captured, the second step is the processing. First, the LiDAR point cloud was obtained by merging the corresponding tiles. Its quality is controlled by means of a set of 21 checkpoints extracted in constructions and building roof corners. They are measured in the field with differential GNSS. The mean vertical error was of 0.24 meters, being the standard deviation, and root mean squares of about 0.45 meters. The historical flights are oriented using a point dataset extracted from LiDAR data as second order GCPs. Then, propagated errors in checkpoints range from 0.50 to 0.95 for the vertical component. UAS flights are aligned with structure from motion multi-view steady techniques. The first flight, taken as reference, was oriented with GCP's measure in the field with differential GNSS. Additionally, second-order GCPs are used for the orientation of the other flight. The orientation produces root mean square errors at checkpoints that do not exceed of 5 centimeters in the vertical component. Next, the generation of digital surface models and orthophotographs are addressed. DCMs are generated with a resolution of 2.50 meters for the historical flights using dense matching techniques. DCM's uncertainties were assumed as the vertical errors computed at checkpoints. The orthophotographs were exported with a resolution of 0.50 meters. From the UGS images, DCMs are generated with a resolution and uncertainty of 10 centimeters. Orth images are generated with a resolution and an uncertainty of 5 centimeters. Both products are resembling to the same resolution as the historical products. The calculation of differential models from DCMs allows the detection of areas that undergo vertical displacements, and this may be negative or positive, corresponding to mass depletion or deposition respectively. The vertical uncertainties of the differential models are estimated in around 1 meter. From these differential models, we delimited manually the galley area in the GIS. Then the depletion and deposition areas could be calculated as the average values of height differences. Finally, the depletion, deposition and balance volumes could be estimated that were transformed to mass rates by surface and time. Climatic data were obtained from the databases of the European for medium range weather forecasts and processing to obtain a grid with a resolution of 1 km from 1970. From daily precipitation data, several statistics have been calculated for rainfalls of 1 day, 7 days, 1 month and 3 months. The results regarding areas, most periods and the total periods presented a predominance of erosion over deposition, but the uncertainty area was very high. Uncertainty was lower in the more active periods 2009-2011 and 2011-2013, where the depletion processes predominate clearly over deposition. In the first three periods, there are few differences. A little bit in the period 1996-2001. In the next periods, the differences are remarkable in the periods 2009-2011 and also in 2011-2013. And finally, in the last three periods, few differences are observed again. Thus, the height differences calculated from DCMs of differences show advance rates for the whole period around 4 cm year. Most balance rates show negative values or near zero, so the erosion predominates, and the balance rates showed absolute values below 5 cm years, except the more active periods when the rates reach 30 to 40 cm year. Regarding the volumes, these were greater for the depletion than for the deposition in most cases. The balance was near 30,000 cubic meters was the volumes, and the mass rate was of around 45 tons by year, by hectare year, but the balance rate reached values higher than 300 tons by hectare years in the more active periods. Finally, regarding the rainfalls, it is observed that the mean annual rainfall was 470 mm and ranging from 200 and 900 mm. A slight increase, 10% of rainfall was observed from the first 5 year period to the last ones. The maximum values in daily rainfalls showed an increase near 30% in the last 5 year period. This value is lower, 10% for 7 days, 1 and 3 months rainfalls. Besides, for periods of 5 years, the number of days in which a rainfall amount has been exceeded was higher in the last 5-year periods than in the first ones, both for 1 day, 7 days, and 1 and 3 months. And for the period considered in the erosion analysis, the periods with maximum number of days with a high amount of daily rainfalls were 1996, 2001, 2009, 2011, and 2011-2013. For 7 days, 1 month, and 3 months, the rainy days were maximum, especially in 2009-2011. Observing the erosion rates, the Gallia Stretch present an intense activity, especially of depression processes respect to the deposition ones. Some periods presented significantly higher values with average incision of 30-50 cm years and the balance mass rates higher than 300 tons hectare by hectare a year. The depletion processes that until 2011 were concentrated in the Gallia Sandstone incision mechanisms from 2011 displaced towards its lateral walls, retraction mechanisms. And regarding the relationships with rainfalls, the higher activity in the more active periods seems to be related to the increase of rainfall in these periods, in which several days had rainfalls higher than 30 mm. There were also events of weekly rainfalls higher than 100 mm, monthly higher than 200 mm, and 3 months higher than 400 mm. Nevertheless, it is difficult to conclude about the influence of climate change on the erosional activity with clear evidence of change in the rainfall regime. A certain increase of the precipitation is observed, especially in the 1 day rainfall, but it is necessary to have longer data sets and more points of analysis. The existence of wet periods with low erosional activity, 1996 2001, led to consider the influence of other factors such as the construction of rural paths and roads and the changes in land use and practices. The conclusions. We have developed an approach to study the erosion processes using aerial and UVIS photogrammetry techniques combined with LiDAR data. The average depletion was of 1.60 meters incision and the waste volume of 30,000 cubic meters, which led to rates of 4 centimeters years and 45 tons by hectare year, reaching values of one order of magnitude higher in the more active periods. These rates are related to rainfalls, being the periods with a more intense erosion processes, those in which the precipitations are higher. Rainfall regime has increased in the last 3 years, but it is necessary more data and analysis to conclude about the influence of climate change in erosion processes. And so, the future works will be led to improve the accuracy of photogrammetric LiDAR techniques and the automation to be applied to larger stations. Then, more advanced techniques of climatic data analysis will be used. Thank you very much for your attention.